You want to control your PTZ camera and you don't want to use an iPad or a web browser. You want something that is intuitive to use, it feels good to touch, is small and light and fits on your table. And finally, you're probably using hardware from different manufacturers, so you're sick of having multiple control points for your video setup. And here is the solution, the SKAARHOJ PTZ Fly. The PTZ Fly has a nice joystick and it has 6 four-way buttons and 4 encoders that offers you very easy and yet flexible control. And it comes configured right out of the box, so all you need is to select your camera and set your IP address. If we look at the default configuration, buttons 1 through 5 is selecting cameras and the 4 encoders are used to change settings. So the upper part of the menu button can be used to change which settings you are currently controlling, and if you use the lower part of the menu button, you toggle between presets and camera selection. But of course you can change the behavior of any button to fit your precise needs. The PTZ Fly is born with IP, so you can plug it into your existing IP network, which means that you already have all the cables to connect it. And if you even have a power over Ethernet switch, this gives you power and signals in the same cable, giving you a nice uncluttered desk space. At the time of this recording, we support more than 30 different models of PTZ cameras and we support equipment from more than 50 different manufacturers. This means that the PTZ Fly probably can control the equipment you're using today, and there's a good chance that we'll support the equipment you plan to buy tomorrow. And we release new integrations constantly and add functionality and options to the existing ones very often. Here we have 3 Newtek cameras connected to the PTZ Fly, and we can control each one of them. So you see camera number 1 is selected and I can control camera number 1 with a joystick. But if I change to camera number 3 on the controller, I have camera number 3 here. And if I press the menu button just once, I access preset recall, and when I press that, this camera goes to its preset. If you look at the upper row, you see that we have access to exposure control for each camera on these knobs, and if I press the menu button, I'll get to the white balance of the cameras. Here is another scenario where we are connected to 2 PTZ Optics cameras, but we are also connected to vMix, and in the camera select row, we are actually also selecting the source for the preview row in vMix. There's then a cut button so we can change between the two. We can also start stop streaming and start stop recording. And what that means is when I press this button, you see it's lighting up in red, indicating that recording is ongoing in vMix. This gives you an idea of what you can achieve with the PTZ Fly, but keep in mind that you can do this with Sony cameras and livestream studios, or OBS and Panasonic cameras, or any configuration that you would like. If you want to learn more about how to configure PTZ Fly, check out our Unisketch basic training videos where I take you through everything you need to know in order to configure the PTZ Fly. And check out the link in the description, and please subscribe if you want to stay updated about development and news from SKAARHOJ.